Hello, and thanks for joining us for the USGNN Monthly Newscast, sponsored by U.S. Glass Magazine. I'm Megan Headley. Let's get started by visiting the recent American Institute of Architects annual convention, which took place earlier this month in San Francisco. AIA reported more than 20,000 registrants, although exhibitors commented almost uniformly on the lulls of traffic. But those lulls led to a curious thing, as many of the glass-related exhibitors we spoke with found that the architects there were more focused specifically on unique applications for glass products than they had been in years past.
The majority of the buildings that we're looking at now are mostly curtain wall buildings, so therefore, in order to really make those buildings have some kind of a characteristic that's unique, we're trying to find ways of using glass in different ways, different varieties.
Another product that we've been, pushing the industry to develop is coated glass, but in patterns. Okay. So, as you know, right now coated glass is only available. It's a full coverage coating, right? So, there's a lot of interest in creating patterns with those coatings. So, if you had a stainless steel or a reflective coating, or even a low E coating with some coloration to it, to be able to put that down in a pattern, so that you could create more, visually interesting projects with that.
Solar glazing also popped up at this convention as a hot topic, as it has at many others in the last year. Decorative glass products also proved alluring to architects.
Our goal for this show was to show all the different applications that you can use decorative glass in. I find that architects and even glazing contractors, the more they know about decorative glass and the more they understand the product, the more that they like to use it.
I've done these shows off and on over the past 20 years, I think. And I don't know, business is really strong, but I thought maybe it'd be good to play really hard offense and just make sure everybody knows that we're still here. A lot of the work that we do integrates art into architecture. And so rather than going out and trying to find all the architects to talk to, we thought we'd just sit here and let them come talk to us.
For more about the show, you'll want to look for the full AIA review in the June issue of U.S. Glass Magazine. But the AIA convention isn't the only place you'll see glass this year. Glass Performance Days is set to take place June 12th through 15th in Finland and will focus on cutting-edge glass technologies. For more on the conference, we turn to Holly Biller. Holly?
Thanks, Megan. Glass Performance Days, the biannual technical conference sponsored by Glaston, will feature approximately 300 presentations, the highest number ever, according to the organizing committee. Organizers note that this year's agenda is strongly focused on solar technology, the fastest growing category for glass processors and their supply chain. An architects forum is another new addition to the schedule. Other tracks, and there are five parallel tracks each day, will cover energy performance in buildings, processing techniques, differences between local versus global markets, new products and applications, case studies, and many others. In addition, 20 pre-event workshops will be held June 11th and 12th. These 4 to 8 hour sessions are designed to provide participants with more in-depth knowledge of various topics. And of course, in addition to the educational sessions, will be some old-fashioned social networking. But this year, attendees can do some modern cyber networking in advance. If you're signed up for the show, you can start scheduling your meeting requests now by visiting www.gpd.fi. Back to you, Megan.
Thanks, Holly. While GPD organizers are gearing up for another big conference, Glaston itself has been facing some challenges in recent months. As part of a company-wide restructuring, Glaston's pre-processing and heat treatment business areas have been merged into one new business area, Machines BA. The company expects to save more than $4 million through the merger. The company also is closing a machine manufacturing plant in Cinnaminson, New Jersey. The manufacture of these tempering lines will be transferred to Finland and China. Glaston representatives say they will maintain the company's North American Technology Center and service offices in Cinnaminson, and it has formed a service delivery center in the existing New Jersey office. In lighter news, some companies in the construction industry are beginning to see improvements as a result of the stimulus bill passed in February. Associated General Contractors Chief Economist Ken Simonson says the infrastructure piece of stimulus is beginning to put construction workers back on the job. Simonson says that as more stimulus-funded projects are awarded, a growing number of AGC member companies are reporting adding new jobs, rehiring laid-off employees, and canceling planned layoffs. Glass industry companies are among those starting to see the impact of the American Recovery and Reinvestment Act. Vice President Joe Biden, together with both Illinois senators and Chicago Mayor Richard Daley, visited the former Republic Windows and Doors at the end of April. Biden used the visit to highlight the Stimulus Act at work. In February, Sirius Materials purchased Republic Windows, and company president Kevin Cerase says that without the Recovery Act, the reopening would not have been possible. Biden told those in attendance that what's happening at Republic gives America hope, and he credited Cerase for bringing back the former Republic workers who were members of the union and for keeping the union intact.
You've done something that is a little unusual. You've recognized, as Dick Durbin said, that the greatest asset that this factory had were the men and women who just spoke, the workers here. And instead of doing what has too often been the case in the last, I would argue, 10 to 15 years, you reached out to the most qualified workers in the world. Instead of saying, if you want to come back, I'm going to break your union, you said, come back, union and all. That's a big deal. That's a big deal.
Cerase says that 70% of the products produced at this plant will be for commercial applications. While the plant is not yet officially reopened, approximately a dozen workers have been brought back and were present for Biden's visit. Now, back in February 2008, Rochester Insulated Glass completed the first phase of a planned expansion aimed at helping the company pursue larger projects. Now, Rochester is planning phase two with the help of a community development block grant from New York State. The expansion is expected to create 40 jobs, 30 of which will be available to low and moderate income workers, and provide the company with new glass fabrication machinery and equipment. Duralco Architectural Systems in Illinois also is expanding, growing its architectural cladding division with additional column cover manufacturing equipment and craftsmen. Company representatives say they've been able to turn the economic downturn into new business through fresh thinking.
Duralco being a smaller, mid-sized to small company, we were able to act fast, and within 2 months of deciding to start a composite panel division, I had hired a division manager with a ton of architectural experience. We had bought a new Axie CNC-controlled machine, found a reliable composite sheet supplier. We designed a system and had it tested to AMA 508-7 standards, and we sold our first job before our machine was even delivered. And now we're doing the same thing. We had other customers come to us and say, you know what, we need column covers. So now we have a roll former being delivered tomorrow. And again, that's the same way. Within almost 3 months, we've ordered that machine. We're bidding composite column covers and stainless steel column covers right now. Machine's going to be delivered tomorrow, actually, and trained the next week, and we're going to be up and running.
Vega is another company benefiting from the Stimulus Act. The PVC profile extruder has launched a commercial door and window program. The Germany-based company has been working with these products for close to a year in an effort to test the potential of these European-style products for North America's marketplace.
The Recovery and Reinvestment Act of 2009 has helped Vivica's commercial vinyl business because it's brought to the forefront the need for energy-saving products, energy-efficient products, and green products all at the same time. And what's going on in the industry, in addition to the Recovery and Reinvestment Act, is we have changes in the 2009 IECC, changes in the ASHRAE requirements, and we have Energy Star putting out a commercial program in October of this year, all looking for lower U values, lower solar heat gain, more energy efficiency in commercial vinyl, commercial windows and doors. Becca is growing by supporting our existing customer base, which fabricates vinyl windows and doors for residential new construction and replacement and remodel. These customers are adding on commercial lines, and we also have traditional commercial manufacturers coming on board to manufacture our commercial vinyl window program.
Now be sure to look for updates on these stories and more on our next U.S. GNN newscast in June, when we'll be bringing the news straight to your screen once again. Thanks for watching.